Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam rasulullah. The title of my talk is Hypertension in Saudi Arabia, and as you can see, it is a vast topic. It can't be covered in 20 minutes, but I'd like to I will highlight on the most pertinent part of it. I have to say that I don't have any conflicting interest, financial or otherwise. Just refresh your memories. Hypertension is a leading risk. Hypertension is a leading risk factor worldwide. It is associated with heart failures, strokes, renal failure, dementia, and complicated diabetes. There is an echo, I don't know why. It's account for 10%, about 10% of the health spending, healthcare spending. Recently, the world leaders recognize the importance of hypertension, and so today we have Hypertension Day, and the United Nations also developed. It's not the right. It should be like this. Right. And the United Nations developed nine chronic diseases targets to be done by 2025, and four of these belong to hypertension, like reducing hypertension by 25%, reducing sodium in our diet by 30%, and increase coverage for medications and devices by 80%, and reduce overall chronic diseases by 25%. In preparation for this topic, I reviewed all what is written in the literature in Saudi Arabia about hypertension, and I found 111 studies done between 1994 and 2018. Looking chronologically on the trend of these studies, you can see that there is an increasing interest in hypertension in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Before 2000, only 10 research papers published. On between 2016 and 2018, we have 41 publications. Regarding the design and setting of these studies, a quarter of them were household, national, or regional studies. Another 25% were campaigns either in educational facilities or commercial malls and other facilities, and about 50% either in hospitals or primary care. This is this overcrowded graph briefly represent the most important aspects of these studies. And as you can see, between 1994 and 2017, we have a change of the prevalence. As you can, the first study was done by Professor Hazmi in 1994, and it shows a prevalence of 4.5 male more than females. This is a household study, national study, where they studied 14,000 participants between the age of 14 and 70. Then 10 years later, Professor Nuzha and his colleagues did the biggest ever national study. This is between the age of 30 and 70. And they found the prevalence of 26.1%. Again, male more than female. Then Daghri studied about 9,000 and found the prevalence of 32%. Alhamdan and Saeed also did a national study in 2006, and they found a prevalence of 25.5. All these studies showed that males are more than females and it increases with age. But when Rubian and his colleague come to study about 12,000 cohort they have, they found a prevalence of 33%. No, it's 34.7%, and the female is more than male now. We did a national study on the elderly, those aged 60 and above, and it was a household national also, and we find a prevalence of 47%. The female is more than the male. Just comparing these Saudi national studies with a study done by Yusuf Ali in four countries in the Middle East, and Saudi Arabia, one of them, and he found a prevalence of 33%. Female is more than female also. And comparing with England and Canada and USA, you can see the prevalence is about 30, except Canada, where it's about 20. And again, the female is more than the male. Is there a regional difference in the prevalence in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia? It sounds so. You can see that more than one study showing that we have a lower prevalence in the south of the kingdom than other regions. And you can see that in the central and eastern is the highest. All these studies were done by Al-Bashrawi. And this is one of the national studies about 12,000 participants all over the kingdom, household 15 years and above. And another study done by Asweda. He's a nephrologist, I think, known to some of us here. This is a campaign in commercial malls. There are several studies done in primary healthcare centers, some of them affiliated with hospitals. All these tell us that the prevalence is around 30, and those known to have hypertension, only about 50% of them know they are aware of their hypertension. And 50% of those aware of hypertension, they are on some type of treatments. And unfortunately, only about 20% were controlled. So the control is low. This is the study by Yusuf Ali, where he studied the hypertension in United Arab Emirates, Iran, Palestine, and Saudi Arabia. And I can see that again, the prevalence is around 30. The awareness is about 50%, and treatment 50%, and the control something around 20%. Saudi Arabia is doing well compared with these places. With the England and United States and Canada, the prevalence is around again 30, except Canada is about 20. But they are doing better than us with the awareness. So the awareness reached sometime 80%, and the treatment is also about 80%. The control is something like about 50% if you take the average. Hypertension in all our studies is a cause existing with diabetes and dyslipidemia. And there is a high risk of overweight. And so over the last 20 years, we managed to maintain a high rate of overweight and obesity around 70%. We did a little bit better with our physical activity. We improved physical activities from 90 to low activity, 90% to 60%. But smoking stays steady at about 12%. And we are not satisfying the World Health Organization recommendation of consuming 5 servings of fruit and vegetables a day. This is an interesting study about salt. This is done by Al-Khnezi in the Eastern Province in the Kingdom of Saudi, where they try to estimate the amount of salt and sodium we consume. So they estimate it in the 24-hour urine excretion, and they found that it is far beyond the recommended sodium intake. Another interesting study is done by Al-Jawalda. I think he's Jordanian. And he studied 8 Arab countries. Saudi Arabia is not part of them, but we are, I think, consuming the same type of bread. They studied the amount of salt and sodium in bread. So they randomized bakeries in these 8 countries and took sample of bread, and they measured the amount of salt in it. And they found that the amount of salt in the consumed bread is at least 3 times more than the recommended amount of salt consumed. Salt is not available only in bread, indeed available in so many, so we need more studies on this. This is Dr. Al-Jilban also studied how health professionals manage their hypertensive patients. And as you can see that there is most of the health professionals, they were not following the guidelines. In conclusion, I think we are talking about a prevalence of about 30% on adult population, it's all the studies, the national study confirmed that it is associated with increasing age, male gender, overweight and obesity, low physical activities, smoking, and consumption of salts. I think there are a lot of gaps which need to be bridged in the coming futures, like, for example, standardize the methodology in our studies using standard valid tool to conduct these studies. And we need to more studies of the nutritional profile of the public and how they are associated with hypertension. I didn't find studies on stress and hypertension. I think this is an area where we should have some studies on it. Also, I didn't find a study with genetic susceptibility with hypertension. I think also we need to do some interventional studies, interventional experimental studies using the simple health promotional procedures. Also we need to again study how health professionals behave with our recent guidelines, for example, and study also the burden of hypertension. Thank you very much for listening.